Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through exception message printing methods, guys. So what are the, there are few methods by using, okay, by using them we can print the appropriate message from the whole exception, guys. I think in one of our tutorials, we have, in the second tutorial, I think so, we have gone through exception handling. So whenever we are doing some exception, it's giving you a 3-4 line message. So is it necessary to have that? Okay, it's giving you an accurate message and in detailed message, but it's not required always, right? So you need a small, short and sweet message, right? So that is the reason why these methods came into play. Fine. Okay, so the first method will be print stack trace. The second method will be toString method. The third method will be get message. Fine. So let us start with print stack trace, guys. So it will print the exception message in the following format. It's going to print the package name, exception message, et, class name, in main or not, file name and line number. So this is all the things that a print stack tray will be printing in detail if you go in clearly. Fine. Okay, so I hope everyone got a small idea on this, guys. Okay, so let us continue. Just give me a second. Okay, I think I have to do it bit of like this. Fine. Okay, so it prints a package name, that is lang package, exception name, arithmetic exception, reason, divide by zero, class name, a method name, main, file name, dot java, that is a dot java, and line number, that is 7. So these are all the things that a print stack tray will be printing. So basically how you can print, how you can use this method is nothing but object dot print stack trace. So that is a small keyword or whatever you may think, it's a syntax basically. So that is the basic syntax for print stack trace. P will be small, S will be capital, T will be capital, as it is a method. Fine. So now let us go through the second method, that is toString method. It is not two, it is two, toString. Fine. Okay, so it will print the exception message in the following format: java dot lang dot arithmetic exception colon divide by zero. That's it. I think the message is a bit short now. So it prints the package name, that is java dot lang, exception name, that is arithmetic exception, and it goes to the reason, that is divide by zero. So this is only the thing that toString method or toString method will be printing, guys. So the syntax will be system dot out dot println object dot toString. So here we are using so system dot out dot println, guys. Fine. Okay, so now let us continue our lecture with the third type, that is get message. So it is clear that get message is nothing but it will be giving you the appropriate message. So it will print the message in the format divide by zero. It prints only the reason divide by zero. The syntax will be system.out.println object.get message. Fine. Okay, so now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So the above three methods must be used in the catch block only. Remember that, guys. That's an important point for a programmer to know. It should be written only in catch block. Fine. So let us take a small example, class exceptional handling demo. Okay, I think I'll be just writing this example, guys, and I'll be posting it in the WhatsApp group and in the Dropbox link, so that you all guys can have access on them. So I'll be writing only the programs, guys, of all the 5 chapters. Okay guys, in that I think everyone can understand the program, so in that we'll be discussing, guys. So I hope everyone got a clear idea. So in the next tutorial we'll be going through, can it be possible to have multiple catch blocks, yes or no? So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you, thanks for watching.